All right, everybody. So I'm going to show you how to identify an ash tree, and specifically a dead or dying ash tree. That way you can find the trees that morel mushrooms associate with a little bit easier. So this right here is a ash tree, and specifically this tree here is dead, but it is still sending up a few little saplings from the base down here, which is still partially alive, I guess you would say. But the first thing that you want to know is the mnemonic to remember certain trees in Eastern Forest is Mad Buck. That's M-A-D Buck, B-U-C-K. And what that is a memorization device for is maple, ash, dogwood. So the M-A-D is maple, ash, dogwood, and then buck is for buckeye. So all of those have opposite branching. So if you look right here, try to get this to focus in, or maybe it'd be easier down here. So you see where the leaves come out here? They're all across from one another, directly across. Sorry if that's not focusing. And that's something that maples do, ashes do, dogwoods do, and buckeyes. I think there's a few others, but those are the major ones. So another good example is this right here is a sugar maple, I believe. And if you look at the branching of it, you can see, sorry about this, this is not the easiest to focus. But yeah, you can see that they're opposite branching. So maple, ash, dogwood. So this is the ash, this is a maple. Let me try to find you an example of an alternate branching tree here, if I can find one. These are all maple and ash, it looks like. All right, either way, I'll put an example up. Hold up. No, bad example. All right, either way, I'll put up an example later. Okay, so the bark is just your typical, it's got this diamondy pattern. But specifically what you want to look for is blonding first, which you can see a little bit of it right here. You see how it's got just this little area of lighter colored bark right there? Now on larger trees, there's going to be giant swaths of that, like, you know, big, you know, couple of feet wide areas. And what that's from is it's from woodpeckers peeling off this bark trying to get to the emerald ash borer larva that's underneath it. Sorry, this is not one to stay focused here, but yeah, so that's an example of where the woodpeckers have peeled the bark away. So it's this light blonde coloring. So this right here, you see that D-shaped hole, looks kind of like a capital D. That is where the emerald ash borer larva emerges from underneath the bark of the tree. So this tree's already mostly dead. Here you see another example of the D-shaped hole with the bark peeled away from woodpeckers. So this ash tree has already died, mostly. Like I said, there's still a few branches down here lower that are still getting some nutrients, so they're still halfway alive. But this is where morels will associate with these dead and dying trees. They'll feed off the roots of these trees, and they'll grow in that area. Yeah, so that's really basically about it. You want to look for blonding. I'll put up a couple of images of what that looks like. You want to look for these D-shaped holes. That definitely tells you it's an ash if you're in an area where emerald ash borer exists. If emerald ash borer hasn't got to you yet, then ash trees are really no better than any other tree looking for morels. But around here, that's where most of the dead things are. Most of our ash are these big dead trees. So for the next probably decade or so, they're going to be decent decent trees for morels to grow under. The leaves, which you can know, you'll tell whenever you find some saplings or something, you'll be able to look at these leaves. So this is one leaf right here. So it's a compound leaf, and it typically has, I think, 7 leaflets. And just like the leaves grow opposite one another, the leaflets are also opposite, except for that one on the tip. And I'm sorry this is so dark, y'all. It's just not wanting to focus in for me here. Either way, there you go. So typically has 7 leaflets, one on the tip, and then 6 more that are on opposite pairs. Pretty distinctive. The only thing that looks similar to this really is a hickory or I guess a walnut to some extent, but they don't have opposite branching. So again, mad buck, maple, ash, dogwood, and buckeyes have opposite branching. Most other hardwood trees have opposite. Alternate. What did I just say? Either way, opposite for maple, ash, dogwood, and buckeye. Alternate for oak and hickory, etc. All right. Thank you all for watching. Stick around. If you stuck around this long, please go ahead and subscribe. And let me know in the comments below if this helped you out.